Ladies and gentlemen, this is Nico Hubbard. Today I'm just going to be very brief about the budget of Kisumu County 2021-2022. And as you are all aware, this budget has been approved, and we have a few comments to make pertaining to Nyalenda B. So let me begin by just acknowledging the fact that the people of Nyalenda B came out in their good numbers to participate in the budget making process. And allow me to say that we have a few comments to make on the rivers. We have an allocation of River Nyamasaria, River Wegwa, River Uru, and River Aleura. Each one of these is 2 million each. So we have a concern on the rivers. Rivers have become a cash cow. People who are working in the cahoots of the county government are making money out of these rivers. There's no work that is going on the rivers, yet every year they budget for the rivers. So in other words, they are eating the rivers in lieu of tab. Gichama ura. Kadanga watch gidenuo. So watch machama ura ni. Nyaka koro room. Yogi chama ura. Yogi magiti mra ura unge. We said that the rivers should be worked on a machine program basis. We know that the county governments or the county executive is working on the machine program with the counties. The way they are doing the rivers is the same way they should do, the same way they are working on the roads with the machines, the same way they should work on the rivers. So what we are saying that there's nothing that can stop them from working on machine program on the rivers. So these rivers have become a cash cow. So we are actually asking the CEC in charge of finance to look into this matter. We have complaints on the matters of the rivers. Secondly, I have issues on the installation of floodlights. My concern is, we have youths who do not have jobs. They are very qualified. It is the same county that has taken them for TVET training, colleges, ACADO and everywhere else. Why do you train them and don't give them jobs? They should come here, and the people who are installing these floodlights should engage the youths or the people who are qualified on the electrical matters to continue maintaining the floodlights on a continuous basis. So this will create jobs for youths. So that we have a concern in. There's no point of bringing consultants elsewhere, fleecing the county of a lot of cash. Yet our youths are here, loitering here, and they are very much experienced. And in fact, they are trained by county government. So that one, we need them to be engaged into these programs. Thirdly, we are talking about the issue of the solar lamps and the giveaway projects, like the car wash machines and the hatcheries. We need to be very sure, how do we identify our groups? Let not be a group that benefits from the hatcheries are benefiting from the car wash. Let's have a program. I want to ask the ward admin and the village admins, let's work on these programs on giveaway so that we ensure that each group benefits from this thing, so that we do not have duplicity on the giveaway programs. Another thing I want to talk about is the Nanga football playground. This is a project that was riddled with a lot of corruption, and it is because of the negligence of the county government. They allowed the contractor to get away with the money. So now that these projects are coming back, I recommended that our PMCs, project management committees, be remunerated. They should be paid so that they become our eye on this project. You cannot do projects on the ground without the proper motivation of the PMCs. This thing would not have taken place if the PMCs had their position. So in other words, it seems we are implementing projects without PMCs. The PMCs must take their role, and they must be paid. You cannot do work for free for a government that is actually working with a budget. If the county government is working the budget, then they should pay our PMCs. So that is a very serious concern. Now, let me talk about the drainage of the western to Western to Wegua drainage, it is the same story. We have projects, we have budget allocations, but there's no follow-up, there's no oversight. I mean, there's no program. That's why I'm asking all the village admins, I'm asking the ward admin, can't we have a program that is engaging, a program that is involving our people? We cannot just put money into projects and we do not have a follow-up. This is just a rip-off. This is a serious rip-off. Let us engage properly, both on the budgeting stage and on the implementation stage. This is the work of us as the citizens to follow up on the budgetary allocations and the implementations of various projects within the ward. So this is what we are asking the MCA of Nyalenda B. Your work mainly was to go and oversight. And we have seen a lot of failure in providing oversight over a county executive. We need the county executive to be oversighted on matters of finance, because the people of Nyalenda B are not getting value for their money. That is a fact. We have money allocations, but there's no value for money in these projects. So it all becomes a waste. So what we are saying is this. Now that the budget has been approved, let us engage robustly on this. Let us properly engage on this matter, because it is of public interest. These are public money. It is not individual money. Si pesa ya mama ya mutu, hii ni pesa ya umma, ya serikali tukufu la Kenya. Na sisi ndio serikali, we are the people. As per Article 1 on the sovereignty of the people of Kenya. Otherwise, asanteni sana, Mungu awabariki the people of Nyalenda and the people of Kisumu County. Asanteni sana. Thank you very much.